this? I found something.
You thought Rivulon was flat.
After something? Looking to interrogate me again, perhaps?
And you thought Rivelon was flat.
You saw what I could not. It seems the malady is quite right about you.
You got through the door. You really are a Godwoken.
I've plenty of fighters for hire. Experts in blades, bows, and bewitchment. So, what'll it be? And who couldn't? I have several who can fight their way out of a corner. A lot of choice, I know.
Keep an eye on the red until the cage is locked again.
The Seeker has removed one of her gauntlets in order to flex her wrist. It bears inflamed marks from where shackles bit into her. She sees you.
You must be starved for company to linger around here, friend. Don't worry. As soon as she changes her tune, you'll know about it. You and half of Rivelon, friend. But no, he hasn't made a sound. Nothing. She just keeps spitting out her name and rank. Having her leader lying next to her must have hardened her resolve. She'll talk eventually.
Bishop Alexander lies supine on a bale. Someone has wiped the bishop's hands clean and folded them neatly over his abdomen. They rise, bruises swell beneath his eyes, and a shallow gash zigzags from his right ear down to his beardless cheek. Unconscious, he looks more boy than bishop. The bishop's white robes are stained with blood and dirt. He appears shrunken in their billowing mass.
Magister Ranley, Corker's mate of the Divine Eminence vessel, Lady Vengeance.
Thank you.
I've plenty of fighters for hire. Experts in blades, bows, and bewitchment. So, what'll it... I've got sword fighters, mages, archers, all willing to fight by your side if the price is right.
Okay, copy. Okay. Okay, Papa. Oh boy. Yep, okay. There was something to fight.
Which way shall I fly? Infinite wrath and infinite...
I've spotted something.
Sorry? Are you cold? Your heart, okay.
For security reasons, please keep this...
No. Away.